Hi everybody, this is Sean Overton with OneStepRemove.com. In this video we're discussing the different kinds of order methods that are available in NinjaTrader, and there are just two. The first one is a managed approach, and it's overwhelmingly the most common. It really handles all of the common methods that you would find intuitive, like enter long, exit long, enter short, exit short, enter long limit. All of them are obviously named and they're very easy to work with. So if you have common strategies like you want a moving average cross or you want the RSI to place trades based on overbought, oversold levels, you use the managed approach, you use the simple stuff. It's usually a breeze to code. You can even use the strategy wizard to come up with it. It takes 10 to 20 minutes from start to finish and you can find out the back test results of your strategies very easily. Alternatively, you could even run them in a live market and they would work almost off the bat without any real debugging or testing, unless you just had a logical flaw. The more complicated version is called unmanaged orders, and those are a lot more difficult to program. Now, the reason is that all of the things that NinjaTrader does for you is not available with the unmanaged orders. So, for example, when you say enter long and then exit long, NinjaTrader is drawing all the connections between what you're exiting and how much and when you entered, and it's figuring all of the details that seem obvious to you as a trader. Now, the computer doesn't make those kind of connections, and when you use an unmanaged approach, you have to do all of those details for you. I will tell you from experience that we only use unmanaged orders for pending orders. So if you have a strategy that likes to enter with limit orders or stop orders, then that's usually the time when we'll switch it over to unmanaged. The reason we do that is it makes it easier to track, and there are some advantages with it. So in the blog post I talk about how for one client we changed his strategy type to unmanaged for the purpose of capturing commissions. Now we could have done this with a managed approach, but I just figured it would be easier to do unmanaged because it's a lot easier to explicitly tell NinjaTrader how to handle things, and you don't have to worry about some of the assumptions that that happen when you're using a managed approach. And in that case, we were able to cut the commissions almost in half by grouping things as single tickets, and that way the broker saw them as one order instead of two orders. And the other thing is that when we were running a strategy, we had a lot of problems with overfills. And an overfill is when you put a pending order in the market and then you try and cancel it. Before the cancel request actually comes to the broker already fills the trade. NinjaTrader tells you that an overfill occurs, and with a managed approach, it kills the strategy, closes a position at market, and then doesn't do anything further. Now, with an unmanaged approach, if you're trying to do something active like a market-making strategy, that's a huge pain because it's going to happen. If you're trading thousands of times a day, you will get an overfill. So what I like about unmanaged is that you can handle those kind of situations and you can tell it to stay in the market and still try and exit, but maybe don't close at market, and you certainly don't need to kill the strategy. You maintain a lot more control, so you get a lot more flexibility. The consequence of that is you put a lot more work into it. If you have questions about whether your strategy is better used for in a managed approach or an unmanaged approach, you can find me at www.onestepremove.com. My name is Sean Overton. Thank you for listening.